Hey everybody, it's Mark Oakley here, outdoors. Thought we'd take a little hike around. I was watching a little, vlog from a friend of mine, Mike Kitchen, and he's been doing like these daily vlogs, just going for a walk outside, and I'm like, man, you know, it's really good to know people who are into the same kinds of things that you're into, because it inspires you. I find like when I'm just doing my own thing, you can sort of, you lose track of your benchmarks, right? And, you know, I find when I'm the way I'm built, is I find having like minds all sort of moving in a similar direction creates a kind of, I don't know, it makes it easier for everyone to move. So I was like, oh, I'm inspired. Plus it's a really, well, I was gonna say it's a really nice day. It's a little gray. It's kind of muddy and cold. I just trekked through a big puddle, but I haven't got a winter jacket on. I've just got my under jacket part, and it's nice out, smells good. Some gross sort of like suburban traffic, muddy puddles, dirty snow, and it feels great because I mean spring's almost here and the air smells good, right? So I thought I'd go for a little hikey, and just see what kind of thoughts I felt like sharing. One cool thing is this little handy cam thing that I'm, action cam, it's a little Sony. It's a Sony, let's see if I can remember all the numbers and letters. It's a, so it's a Sony HDR-AS-300. And it's a really cool little camera, and it came out quite a long time ago. One of the things that's neat about it is that, let's go hiking down this little road here, get off the main drag, and can talk to myself without having to fight with traffic. And anyway, one of the neat things about this camera is that it has like a little sensor inside that bounces around. It's like held in place by magnets and springs, mechanical damping. The newer cameras like this, like the GoPros, they have digital stabilization. Digital is better. It's smarter, faster, stronger. And it kind of works now, you know, like you look at the cameras that have good digital stabilization, the more modern ones, and they do a pretty good job. But and getting to that point, everything looked like you're in a weird video game. It was like your computer's trying to determine, you know, what level is and what parts are supposed to be not shaking. There was this one mode, I think it was like the GoPro 8 or 9, where this technology was first being sort of introduced. it was so weird. Like the background would stay perfectly stable, but the subject was able to move around. It was almost like it was separating objects. I don't know how it was doing that. Or you could sort of, I see how the computer got to that stupid choice. Anyway, this one's purely analog, and we're gonna try it right now. So I'm shaking the camera. Do you see a lot of shake? You probably see a little bit. But just as I'm walking, the bounce in my step is probably not jarring. Anyway, so that's kind of neat. The other cool thing is I was going through like a little purge of technology, because as I was sort of building studios and getting into, you know, experimenting with vlogging, I ended up buying a whole bunch of equipment. Things that seemed like a really great idea at the time, but then later on you realize, I'm not using this, or this thing's awkward, or, you know. I got these like a stick with like little actuator motors on it that would hold a camera steady. So now your big heavy camera's on a stick that would, you can move your hand around and the camera would just stay rock solid. It seemed like a really cool idea, and it was just so awkward and annoying, and you couldn't put it down. If you tried to hold the camera, you couldn't tell it to like, okay, I want to turn and show you that thing, and you'd turn your hand, but the camera would just stay locked on your face like you told it to. So you found yourself like psychologically boxing with a really dumb AI that's just really trying its best to do what you tell it to do. And anyway, it was just so annoying. And then the funniest one was like, okay, I'm just gonna grab the camera, let go of the stick, and point it at the subject that I wanna do. And so when you do that, the stick suddenly starts spinning like crazy. The motors go nuts. Oh, what's happening? Gravity's gone away. And so now you have this crazy, and then you hold that, and then it's like, I'm being locked. And it starts beeping an alarm at you. It was just like this total nightmare contraption that cost like $200. And I was like, well, that's useless. So I threw it in the box. You know, multiply that experience a couple dozen times and you'll wind up with boxes of crap, right? And I'm like, I hate e-waste. I hate the concept of taking all this, you know, these expensive rare earth minerals and all this money and labor time and building these really cool things only to sort of, kind of works, and then throw it in a box and eventually it ends up in a dump. I'm like, man, that's just, you know, I could, you know what, let's sell this stuff on eBay. So I've been selling bits and pieces off, and this camera came up because I haven't used it in like quite a long time, because I've got like a desk set up now and these cool mics and a studio thing, which is really great. And it's a higher tech sort of image. It looks really good. This little thing, so well, maybe it's time to sell the Sony HDR-AS300 with a dash in there. And so I go online to sort of see these things they're not made anymore, and they're very, very, you know, people who want them really want them. Like the price tag on new ones, if you can find them, because they'll sort of make a bunch of new ones, box them up, ship them to a warehouse, sell most of them, and there's like 10 left. And those 10 are suddenly worth like over $1,000 each. I got this for, I think it was like $400, $450 or something like that, new when I got it. You know, the used ones are selling for like $500. Holy smokes, they've gone up in value. That's weird, you know. I think it might have something to do with the sort of the, you know, transportation and technology bottlenecks that have been happening. Like they were saying, the global chip shortage is due to these three or four different factors. It's a big problem. There's some really interesting reasons behind it, but one of which is that, well, Sony, for instance, will have like, this is our new line of cameras. There's three of them. They're really good, except only this one is available. These other two, you have to get on a waiting list, and this third one, we just shut the factory down because we have no parts, you know? So things are getting, it's like, people in the internet age and the vlogging age, everyone wants to get online, and there's already a heavy demand, and the ability to make and ship this stuff has gone way down. So it's like a big problem. And so I've got all these cameras that are going up in price. I'm like, oh, that's bananas, man. I'm more or less happy if I can just get a reasonable amount of cash back. So if I were to sell this little thing, we'll see. I'm gonna take this video home, see what it looks like. Maybe I want to do more of these walking around videos. But if I do decide to sell it, I'd sell it for like way less than the next guy, just because I've gotten some good use out of it. It's used. Maybe someone out there doesn't want to spend half their paycheck on a piece of consumer electronics, as amazing as this is, but it's still like getting pretty old. I think it came out in 2014 was when it came out, so that's it's an 8 year old piece of equipment. You know, that's what an interesting phase of our economy and culture that we're in right now, where, yeah, our relationships with China, for instance, for the only instance where stuff is made, is everything's been shifting, everything's a little uncertain. So technology might become really hard to come by. Part of me, you know, the mercantile part of me was thinking, hold on to it for even longer, it'll go up, wait, you know, I'm big in value. If inflation hits, the Canadian dollar will go down and the value of your equipment will go up. You know, maybe. But the more practical, you know, immediate part of me is just looking at boxes of crap. And maybe it's time to unload some things. But it kind of comes down to, how good does this video look? Anyway. It's getting a little loud out here. Maybe I'll, I think I'm going to call that a video. Wish you all well. Let's wave to the traffic. And we'll catch you guys in. Again, in another video. Cheers.